I heard about this very special German person who is following the trace of the most ancient Indian instrument. And it so happened that he learned from one of the last masters who were making the instruments, and those masters disappeared, and the knowledge basically came into Carsten's lab. He's here since 25 years in India, following that sacred song line of the Rudra Veena. We will not spend too many words. It's a very unique sound. Carsten has worked for many years to refine it. I think we just welcome you for a very special event, very rare event. There's maybe only a few exponents of the Rudra Veena. He just recently came from a festival. There was a Rudra Veena festival in Goa and in Bangalore. There's a handful of people who play that instrument, and it's so beautiful, I think symbolic also to Auroville, that actually the preservation of the ancient tradition and its innovation into the coming time of our future, of a global future, it actually really happens through the intermingling of cultures and enhancing our cultures with each other. Welcome to Carsten this evening.
Well, the room has enough acoustic. I was a bit afraid whether everybody can hear me. So, namaskar, good evening. It's really blowing me away, I have to say so. I think I never in India have seen this average age we are having present here, because normally we say Indian classical concerts 50 plus, and classical tradition. It's all good. Oh, now we have the gallery also filled. Oh, man. Can't believe that. There's still space here if you want to. Otherwise, okay. So, well, it doesn't matter whether I come on stage in Kolkata and Delhi, or now in Auroville, or it is in Berlin, or whatever, Paris, London. Most of the time, the people coming to the concert see the very first time this instrument, this very ancient instrument called Rudra Veena. We often call her also the mother and the queen of Indian string instruments. I'm not going in detail now into the history, but the ancestors of this instrument have been around for the last 1,500, 2,000 years. And the instrument has been very popular in the medieval age, being an accompanying instrument, first of all, for a vocal style called Dhrupad. I think tomorrow, even here in Auroville, there's a chance to listen to the vocal form of it. I'm really, really impressed what's going on here. I'm the first time here. I played last week a concert in the Tantrasaf, and I was supposed to go actually on Friday, last Friday, a week ago, towards Varanasi, playing there in the Dhrupad Mela for Mahashivratri. And then that's apparently Pondicherry in Auroville. It doesn't let you go. So this is a third concert we are doing here with the Veena. And even normally what we would have, a rhythmical accompaniment along, but since we improvised it from one day to the other to do the concerts, we don't even have the accompanist here, which is not so bad, because the main form, what we play on the Rudra Veena anyway, is what we call Alap, Jhala. It's the exploration of the raga in its emotional moods, and that's basically what you also hear in the vocal form of that music. And there are very few instruments which go along with this old Dhrupad style. So the main difference, if you otherwise have heard a Hindustani classical concert on bansuri, on sitar, sarod, whatever, is that we dwell really long and slowly, slowly, gradually unfolding the raga in its moods, in its swaras. You can imagine like you have a white wall, and then you start to paint one dot, one line, Then you connect them, one color, a little shade of a color, and then slowly, slowly the picture of the rag comes up. That is the main thing. Well, it's a beautiful thing, but it requires something from the audience, which is apparently rare today. Patience. And second, attention. Everybody of us knows how short our attention mostly reaches. I have to include myself, finding myself doing yoga or meditation and not being immune to having the curse of the age beside. And so the beautiful thing with this is once you can open up yourself, it doesn't matter much whether you know about what is a raga, what is this instrument, what is this music. Most of the time, even when I play in the Western countries, people who listen the very first time to that sound, I can very well understand when they ask themselves, now where is the music in that? It's like my grandmother once listened to the practice and then after 1-2 hours she came to me and said, but boy, this is always the same. And I knew what she meant, you know. It's just sound. It's abstract sound. But the power of that sound, that is something I would dare to say you cannot find with anything else. At least I couldn't find with any other instrument. So when I'm traveling around with what I affectionately like to call not the Veena but the Kweena, because that's what she is to me, 10 kgs, and with the box it's 35 kgs. Then we carry a bit of baggage, so easily we're on 60 kgs. Going by train, because the flight you can't even pay. So now you know what it means to carry on a tradition from the old days. But whenever I think, you know, could you not ease it up in a way? Could you not maybe, or people used to joke, you know, like, why didn't you choose the bansuri? And then in a way it's not wrong, because the old version of that instrument used to be made from bamboo. Today we make a much more sturdy version. That's basically also how Aurelio and myself, we met and immediately connected about the question, how do you manufacture an instrument like that? It's a much different thing, but definitely it's a part of the whole story. Will this sound continue to be heard in the 21st century or not? As Aurelio already mentioned, I just came from 2 Rudra Veena festivals, which also I have never seen in my life before, within 2 weeks. So we have practically a handful of persons performing and teaching, continuing this tradition now all over India. And well, at times when my Guruji was still alive, Ustad Asad Ali Khan Saab, we sometimes had the feeling it will be the end of it. But right now, also like when I see you all sitting here, I get the feeling there is a new audience, there will be people who will continue to dedicate themselves to it, and let that be the spirit of this evening. I'm going to start the evening with the first raga. Okay, it's time to put on the sound, huh? Short, close your ears, because I have to switch something on. It might give an unpleasant sound. Yeah. Expecting that. Thank you. So it's such a big instrument, and we had on Tuesday, we had the rare chance of having an acoustic concert in a gallery in Pondicherry, which is really rare, because one of the special features about this instrument, including its ancestors, it never has been constructed in the normal way we would construct today musical instruments, to be sounding loud, to be heard by people. This was an instrument right from the beginning being played mainly for giving vibration, not even acoustic vibration too much, but rather vibrations towards the body, to the player. And then slowly it has developed into an instrument which was played at the courts as an accompanying instrument, later as a solo instrument, but it stayed back in having this very introvert, subtle sound. It's a very, very subtle sound which basically takes you on a journey. There's a lot of mythology about the instrument. We'll not go too much into it. Rudra, one of the names, Raudra, of Lord Shiva. So mythology talks about, like, Shivji would invent this instrument while meditating over the beauty of Parvatima. And, well, the main thing, I think that's not different 2,000 or 1,500 years ago and today. It can really take you to places if you just open up yourself. So let's go on the journey. The first rag I'm going to play. It's a lovely evening raga, which includes a sort of sweet romantic mood, but at the same time has a certain depth. The name is Bageshree. So I hope you can all enjoy, and with your blessings and your good wishes, we will just start.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Deeply impressed. I don't think I ever had listeners.
Heightened performance.
Now we actually all the time have listeners from above, but we don't see them actually. So that's amazing. Really, really. Thank you, Auroville. Thank you, Pondicherry. Thank you, everybody. Coming and, I mean, giving yourself. So, what's the time now? Oh, okay, it's not bad. Yeah. You still got some time, or?
Yeah.
Great.
Here and on the floor above. It's about the genius of India. It's curated by Professor Banerjee from the California Institute of Integral Studies. And I think tomorrow there are some artists in residence in the gallery, and there's an exhibition opening at 4:30 also tomorrow.
Everybody ready? Fasten seat belts? No. You can fly as high as you want. You can dive as deep as you want. That's actually what the Veena gives you, offers you. So it's up to you what you do with it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
applause to you all. you made it. Seriously. I mean, we are the ones who do a bit of action here, but whoever comes and listens and gives his attention, his time, his energy, is as important. The whole what has built up here, everybody is a part of it. So when Aurelio, and once again, big, big thanks to Aurelio.
Actually, thank you to the whole team. It was Puntipa who organized it, Stuart on the sound, and Jeff on the visuals. Also, big thank you to Kalakendra, beautiful gallery. Tapas, she couldn't come, she was not well tonight, that she offered the place. And really, we haven't had such a turnout in long, no? And very touching, actually, that it is for an ancient instrument bridging something into an unknown future, I guess.
Oh no, I know the future already.
Good for you.
So what I wanted to say, Aurelio was asking me, do you want a big hall or a small hall? So I said, see, the intimacy of a smaller one, like we have it here now, that's actually where you can build up the best. But what I didn't tell him is actually, I wanted you all to be close, because that's not only a concert for me today, that's actually my birthday party. Aww. So, that was not what I expected. So thanks for not only making my day, making my evening, and I really, really hope you're all going to continue listening. I mean, never, ever the access to this beautiful sound has been so easy as it is today. If I remember how I came into it 30 years ago, how much struggle, how much search it was. So I'm definitely sure Veena will be back and it will be a part of Auroville and maybe in a much bigger term than we can see today, but I see a future. Thanks again.
Just for everybody to know, we're entering Auroville's birthday week. There's a program every day, and I just heard that on Tuesday in the big auditorium, some very special classical Manipur dance.
All of you are welcome, and every day there is a program. They will have Kalaripur here at the open amphitheater at 7 o'clock also, then sitar. And then 24th is there off there, or maybe there is something. Again, 25th we have Jugalbandi. So every day there is something, and all of you are most welcome. We are staying back till 28th,
On the 28th, actually, in the evening, there is a child prodigy on the Veena. If you are interested in this, it's for me one of the most amazing young musicians, just about turned 20. Grew up in Ramana Maharishi Ashram, an amazing child prodigy and a young hope for the future of Indian classical music. Ramana on 28th. Yeah. Okay, celebrate with us. We need it. I've been going through different challenges, but we're here to celebrate and generate fresh energy for a bright future. Thank you.
the chance to come close. Have a look, have a darshan of the Veena.
So gefangen in der Musik, also es war wirklich.